Mitraya Namaha, welcome to VS Pitanet channel Energy Circles, and today we are going to talk about take care of your hearts. People think there's single heart. No, there are two hearts actually. Two hearts. One heart is here, the left side, exactly of this size, and that's heart. The other heart is your calf muscles, the leg calf muscles. For the lower body, the heart is your calf muscles, right? So, if you can manage these two well, you will really live longer, healthier, right? So, heart is a beautiful organ. It is designed to work for 100 long years. 100 years, no doubt about it. Heart is an involuntary muscular organ where you don't have to say heart to function. Heart keeps functioning, right? Heart keeps functioning. So it's an involuntary function, and there are so many sympathetic and parasympathetic supply to it, which will dictate whether heart to become bradycardia or tachycardia or rhythm, arrhythm. There's so much to heart. But now, being a maxillofacial surgeon, I have a certain understanding about heart. Heart is very, very important, and heart dictates our general perception as general aura as well. If your heart is good, it's not the physical heart. If heart is good, you know what I mean, that is the aura or the heart of a person is good, then your life will be beautiful. Heart has got basically four chambers, but divided into two parts. That is your auricles and your ventricles. And this is a ventricle. These are the auricles. And suppose if you observe it carefully, your heart, the left systemic aorta, that is the left side of the heart, has got big turning, big aorta, big vessel, okay? That's called left systemic. It's entire for supplies major part of the body. That's left systemic aorta, or aorta, that's big one. And very interesting thing here, if you observe, heart is a selfish organ. If you observe carefully, heart is a selfish organ. The moment the branch, that is left side supplies the pure blood, right side is impure blood. Left side of the heart, the moment it pumps the pure blood into circulation, first thing the heart will supply to itself. Okay, the first branches of left systemic aorta, that is the aorta which is supplying the pure blood, will supply to itself. The first thing that heart does is it supplies to heart muscles itself. The pure blood goes to first heart itself. So the point is, heart is a selfish organ. So it says, always, always take care of yourself first. Before helping someone else, before doing anything to someone else, take care of yourself. But the point is, heart is that coronary vessels are very, very small. If you see the coronary vessels, they are very, very small, and they supply to itself, to the heart muscles, supplied by the coronary arteries. Whenever there is any block, they say heart attack, cardiac heart attack, there is a block here in this. So in case if there is a heart attack, that is the coronary vessels gets diseased, or there is a plaque formation there, it's called coronary artery disease. Okay? So heart is supplying itself, and if there is any block in that, that's called coronary artery disease. Now, whenever you are thinking about heart, remember these two points, very, very important. First is, if you are not taking care of yourself, right? First, always, as a rule of spiritual as well as scientific, take care of yourself. Heart is an indicator that heart always takes care of itself first, then to the rest of the body. So first take care of yourself. This is a learning the heart will give us. Take care of yourself. And in case You want the coronary vessels to be healthy. It's called CAD. Normally, you can see in all the doctor's description there. Coronary artery disease. In case your coronary arteries have to be clean and smooth and flowing well, then I want you to remember this. You have to keep moving, keep your body moving. The more your body is moving, the more your coronary arteries gets. The blood supply is nice, and whenever heart is pumping, your heart is good. Whenever it is resting for too long, eating all the fatty food, or too much of rest, too much of lethargy, or there are so many factors for it, smoking, alcohol, something of that sort, all these causes heart to become weak. This is the first thing I want you to learn. So forget about the medical aspect, but first thing what heart teaches is take care of yourself. First, next is very, very important, keep it pumping. Right? Keep it pumping. Always make sure that heart does nice job every day. Exercise for the heart, very, very important. Keep it pumping. The next important part is calf muscles. The calf muscles is the heart for the lower part of your body. Suppose you want your lower part of the body to be healthy. If your lower part is not healthy, your upper part will slowly deteriorate for sure. So lower part of your legs, your thighs, your calves, your feet have to be healthy. To keep that healthy, I want your calf muscles to be healthy. Calf muscles keep pumping your blood. The peripheral cooling will not happen if your calf muscles are good. They act as a pump. So suppose you have peripheral cooling, or you are sitting for a very long time, you are bedridden, you are not ambulatory, then the problem is your calf muscles or your lower part of the body may develop deep vein thrombosis, and that can again go back to your heart, go back to your lungs. It can go to any part of your body and cause a thrombus, and it can cause an attack. So calf muscles have to be healthy. Calf muscles, if you observe carefully, they are like a pump. Okay, so for that, again, two important things. Take care of your calf muscles. Keep them pumping. So how do you do that? How do you do your calf muscles to be pumping? So for this, it's very, very easy. Two important aspects is, first is this side of your muscle, this side of your muscle, preferably on the left side. If you can massage daily this side with your right hand onto the left side, and with your left hand on the right side, if you can massage them daily, your heart is, suppose you are unable to run, suppose you are unable to do exercise, then remember this part and this part, massage them regularly. Suppose you are bedridden, ask someone to do massage this part and this part. That will keep your heart stronger. The second is your calf muscles. To keep your calf muscles healthy, I want you to stand on your toes for at least 30 times per single session, and do it for 3 or 4 times. That way, if your calf muscles are active, I'm sure you'll be healthy for a longer time. Right? These two. So, this is the scientific part, but the spiritual part is, suppose if your calf muscles are healthy, calf muscles are moving, one part of your aura gets cleansed quickly. Your calf muscles are very, very important. So that will remove your lethargy, that will improve your libido, that will improve your ojas, that will improve your energy to perform your day-to-day activities. That will connect you slowly towards your higher sources. That's why either increase your calf muscles activity, or at least when you are unable to move, at least massage them, press them. There are, they are tight socks which you get to, they keep pumping the blood at the calf regions. So in case in case you are able to you are able to move well and good, keep your legs moving, keep your calves calf stretch. If you are unable to move, then you can just ask someone to massage that area, or you can put a you know, some kind of pressurized with some kind of stick like thing. You can keep pumping them, keep moving them. That way it will give you a lot of health, and it will increase your life as well as it will increase your aura, right? Hope this video will help you, and I will see you in the next video. Until then, please take care and Mitraya Namah.
Mitraya Namaha. Welcome to Energy Circle's VSP 1080 channel. Thank you for the amazing response. Please do not forget to pass it on and subscribe. Thank you very much. Aditya Sakshi, Sampurna Rakshana.